Cardiac electrophysiology is a branch of cardiology that studies the heart electrical system. This next segment has been sponsored by Prairie Cardiovascular, where today we're sitting down with Dr. Saha, the director of cardiac electrophysiology at Prairie Cardiovascular, and how he's helping those with abnormal heart rhythms.
Within cardiology, there are subspecialists, and there's, I like to think of it as electricians and plumbers. So the interventionalists are doing all the stent work. They're the plumbers, and then the electricians are the electrophysiologists. So we deal with heart rhythm abnormalities in terms of atrial fibrillation, slow rhythms in terms of something we call bradycardia that we have to put pacemakers in for, and that kind of thing. So atrial fibrillation is a common arrhythmia that a lot of patients have, where the heart has an irregular rhythm, which is very fast and doesn't feel good when the heart's flipping and flopping in their chest. And so one of the things that we can do is with a catheter, we go up the leg into the heart and we cauterize around the tissue that causes this AFib to happen, and we're able to keep people from going into AFib, and that makes them feel better. In addition to that, atrial fibrillation is the most common cause of stroke in the developed world. So we have to make sure that people are on their blood thinners, and we check them to make sure that they're protected. And if they have trouble with blood thinners, that's where another procedure we can do, which is called a watchman or a left atrial appendage occlusion device. That's something that we also do to help people navigate how to mitigate their stroke risk. AFib is a very multifactorial disease, meaning that there's a lot of things that we kind of see that make it worse. A lot of those things are lifestyle issues in terms of being overweight, having sleep apnea, diabetes, hypertension, all the unfortunate things that kind of happen with age. So the more that we treat the people's blood pressure, the more that we treat their sleep apnea with CPAP machines, the more that we help, you know, getting them hooked up with a good weight loss program, and all those lifestyle management things can help keep their AFib managed in a way that the ablation sticks better, or in addition, or even preventing them from having an ablation in the first place. If you're interested in learning a little bit more about cardiac electrophysiology, you can check that out on our website.